Hello! If it's your first time here, I'm Duca.
I'm Roberta.
And we are a Brazilian couple that's about to start building our own shipping container home.
If you're curious about small living spaces and do-it-yourself construction, make sure to subscribe to our channel.
And to come back every week for our weekly episodes of Living Time, where we're gonna post every week the progress of us building our own tiny house. So, let's get to it! We're back, finally, day one. What are you doing today?
Today we are going to mark some points in the land to do the foundation, to put the containers.
Yeah, actually today is the really important day because the place we decide today is the place our house is gonna be for a while, at least. And we still need to approve with the owner of the land, if he allows. Yeah, my dad, but still. It's his land, so we kind of need to tell him where we want to put the containers so he approves and say it's okay. And I told him in 2 days we're gonna be done with the location, so let's get to work. I never turned this on my life, ever in my life, so let's see how it works. Step one, hold here. Step two, here. Step three.
Well, what was supposed to take 2 days ended up taking a lot more than that. But I guess that's normal when we are learning and we have never done this before. So let me try to explain the process. In order to start the site marking and excavation, which was the first step on the process of building the shipping container footings, Duca prepared a few pieces of wood that were used to represent each corner of the containers and also to attach a nylon string that represented the sides of the containers. Well, this was the first mistake. But let's talk about that later on.
Yep. Now we have all the wood we need. Time to
hammer.
Mark. Yep. Time to mark the
everything.
Land.
It's funny how sometimes a task can become so much more complicated on practice if compared to the theory. Placing the first string was really simple. We basically needed to decide the location of one side of the container, and that didn't take too long. But after this first simple task, things start getting confusing. The main problem was how to create a perpendicular line, or in other words, how to locate the other side of the container.
After discussing for a while, we gave up and decided to search for a solution on YouTube. And of course, we found one. One way of doing a perfect 90 degree angle is to create a rectangle triangle with known distances. We decided to use 3, 4 and 5 meters, that means if the sides of the triangle are 3, 4 and 5 meters, in theory, the angle between the 3 and the 4 meter side will be a 90 degree angle. I say in theory, because on the field, it's not as easy as it seems.
So, what do you still need to do?
One more line to measure. Yeah, we have just one more straight line from there to there, and one from there to there, and you're done. And then we have exactly the size of the house and where the house is gonna be.
That's good.
So we are almost there. Excited. Primeira sem trabalho.
What?
First labor accident. First day, done.
That's it.
I guess it's gonna look good. We're excited. I mean, at least now we know where our house is gonna be. So,
we think.
Yeah. Nope, this episode's not over yet. That's just the end of the first day. So make sure to stick with us because there's a lot more to come. Let's get to work.
Do you remember when I said we are learning? I was not joking. This is the second day of our shipping container home construction, and guess what? we needed to do the footings marking all over again.
One of the reasons was the decision of changing the location of the house. We decided to move the house almost 2 meters towards the south part of the land, but that wasn't the main problem. Let me give you an advice. If you intend to mark a site using wood sticks and a nylon string, make sure to use extra long sticks. In the end, the sticks we used were too short, and it was not possible to attach the string on level, as in the west and in the north part of the land, the ground level is 30 centimeters lower. To be honest, we also didn't really like the results we got on the second day. So, as you guys have already seen this before, I guess we can skip this part and go straight to the day we started getting things right, the fourth day. But first, one explanation. The first big mistake we did when we tried to mark the container footings was positioning the nylon strings. Basically, the big mistake is that we used these little wooden sticks to mark this corner of the container, and we use a nylon string to connect them and mark the sides of the container. And that in the future was gonna become a big problem, because you can imagine how can we excavate each footing without taking the wood off place. So that means it's just like not a good solution. So this was a big mistake. If we did right, that's the way it should look. So the wood sticks are far from the corner of the container. All the corners are free, so we can dig on the ground here. So now we can dig the corners so we can place the footings.
So let's get back to the beginning. But first, let's take off the old marks. Just to be clear, we said we didn't want to pay for someone to build the house for us, but that doesn't mean we won't get any help. This day, our friend Pettinati stopped by to give us a hand. So, we started by placing the reference line, that in this case is the east side of the house. And this time with longer sticks and using a water leveler to make sure we have the same level on both ends of the nylon string.
Bora?
Meio centímetro.
Deu?
0,2.
Deu?
Tá no nível.
In order to achieve a better precision on the perpendicular and parallel strings, this time we use the triangle method in a different way. Well, let me try to explain. Basically, we got three different lines with three different colors. And then we get one of the lines and measure 3 meters. That's the blue line. Then we get the orange line and we make a knot cross with the blue line and measure 4 meters. We get the 4 meters and do another knot with the red line and measure 5 meters with another knot here. So basically, if the red line is 5 meters, the blue line is 3 meters, and the orange line is 4 meters, that means we have a perfectly 90 degree angle. So what we actually got the lines and did exactly this on site, and after that was done, we were sure that the line that we just did like this and like this were perpendicular, so we could get our wooden sticks and stick on the ground and stick on the ground and stick on the ground. And that's how we finally got the angles right.
Well, I guess you guys must be curious about these big precast concrete pieces spread around the site. So, let me explain what's going on. We had the idea of searching for pieces of precast concrete wastes and use them as part of our footings. And that's what our shipping container footings are going to be made of. With the help of a friend that owns a big truck, we transported 14 pieces measuring 20 cm by 30 cm by 92 cm each. Well, these other small pieces were not necessary, but they were too cute not to be used, so we still need to find a use for them. We actually got all these pieces as donation, and that became a new challenge, to find a solution for the footings using this batch of pieces.
After a few attempts, we came up with this layout for the footings. The two containers together will form an L shape, and for that, on this specific lane, we decide to use four individual footings that are these ones, and two double footings that are these ones. In order of leveling the site ground, we decided to dig a square hole with bigger dimensions if compared to the precast footings, and a second deeper round hole on the center of the footing. After that, it was time to start cutting the rebars. Oh, before I forget, the guy helping me here is Fabio, another friend. Actually, he was the one that came up with the idea of the lines to fix the angle problems. He also has his own YouTube channel, so if you are into fitness, make sure to check out his channel. The link is on the description below.
Well done, guys.
So, I guess for now it's done. Let's go for lunch.
Yay, best part.
Lunchtime. Well, after lunch, Fabio had something else he needed to do. So now, by myself, and with the proper safety gear, it's time to finish the rebars. With all the mesh rebars done, we still needed to cut some extra rebars for the center holes. After that, we attached them together using a new wire.
So tomorrow we come here, make the concrete and put the concrete, and that's it?
Well, not really. At this point, we still needed to do two more things. First, to make sure the mesh rebar wouldn't touch the ground, we spread some rocks in between the mesh rebars and the ground. Second, we still needed to do the foam work in a few places where the footing needed to be over the ground level. Now, just to make sure. Good enough. Not 100% perfect, but... With all the foam work done, it was finally time to start producing concrete. I first put some water into the concrete mixer, then I added gravel to the recipe, and after that, it was time to add cement, sand, and some extra water. I let it mix for a while, and the first batch of concrete was done. What we are doing here is trying to make sure there are no bubbles on the mixture, otherwise it will have empty spots inside. In other words, weak spots. Well, we thought this step would be quicker, but after repeating the process a few times, we realized that it would take much longer than we planned. So, we decided to divide this process in 2 days. But to make sure we are doing the right thing, we took a day in between to check out the results of the first day. Perfect?
Yeah.
Next one? Yep, we did a good job. But as this is a slow and heavy step of the building process, for the second concrete day, we invited two friends to help. Michael was the responsible for the mixture of concrete, while I carried the loads. André, our other friend, was the responsible for flying the drone. And Roberta was in charge of a really important step of the process. She was the responsible for making sure all the footings were on the right level.
Well, like always, this was just the theory. In order to get the job done, in the end, everyone was doing everything.
I don't know if it was possible to understand 100% of the solution we used for the container's footings. So, I hope this drawing helps. This is how it will look like. In the end, all we are gonna see are the precast footings and the containers on the top. Well, I guess now we just need to be patient and wait for the containers to arrive. So, see you guys next Monday! So, today is day one. What are you doing today?
I don't know.
you know, it's day one and we have English problems already.